Keep them blessings. I'm Pastor Sheila. Are you ready to be blessed, revived, and refreshed? Well, it's time for Moed Shelraga, the appointed time of refreshing. Let's go to the Word of God. Come on, let's go, let's go, let's go to the Word of God. Let's go to be blessed and refreshed. Let's go to the Word of God. Come on, let's go. 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 Come on, let's go to be blessed and refreshed. Is coming from the Gospel according to St. Mark, chapter 6, verses 47 to 52. I'm reading from the Life Application Study Bible. It says, during the night, the disciples were in their boat out in the middle of the lake, and Jesus was alone on land. He saw that they were in serious trouble, rowing hard and struggling against the wind and waves. About 3 o'clock in the morning, he came to them, walking on the water. He started to go past them, but when they saw him walking on the water, they screamed in terror, thinking he was a ghost. They were all terrified when they saw him, but Jesus spoke to them at once. It's all right. He said, I am here. Don't be afraid. Then he climbed into the boat and the wind stopped. They were astonished at what they saw. They still didn't understand the significance of the miracle of the multiplied loaves, for their hearts were hard and they did not believe. And the note says, the disciples were surprised to see Jesus walking beside them on the water, but they should have realized that Jesus would help them when they were in trouble. Though they had lost sight of Jesus, he had not lost sight of them. His concern for them overcame their lack of faith. The next time you are in deep water, remember that Christ knows your struggle and cares for you. The disciples were afraid, but Jesus' presence calmed their fears. We all experience fear. Do we try to deal with it ourselves, or do we let Jesus deal with it? In times of fear and uncertainty, it is calming to know that Christ is always with us. To recognize Christ's presence is the antidote to fear. My beloveds, my dear brothers and sisters, this is an awesome passage of scripture. Here, the disciples are in the boat, and they're in the middle of the lake, and there is a terrible storm, winds and waves, and they're fearing for their life. But the interesting thing is, Jesus sees them, and he sees that they're in trouble. But in all the trouble that they have, what are they doing? They're trying to deal with the situation on their own. No one cried out for Jesus. No one was praying. They were just trying to deal with the situation themselves. And even as Jesus was coming, they didn't even recognize that it was Jesus. He was about to pass them, and they didn't recognize. They just were so in a stage of fear that they were afraid that Jesus was a ghost. There's a lesson in all of this. Sometimes when we're in the middle of our challenges, we're in the middle of our storm, we forget to pray, we forget to call out to Jesus. And even when Jesus is right there, we don't even recognize him. Sometimes we're afraid and we think that it's the enemy. But it's Jesus right there waiting for us to call out to him. And soon as they cried out, but they cried out in fear. They cried out screaming. And Jesus said, wait a minute, I'm here. It's me. Don't be afraid. It's all right. Isn't it interesting that even though they didn't recognize Jesus, Jesus recognized them, and Jesus' first response was to calm them down, to say, it's all right. I got this. Don't worry about it. It's me. I'm here now. Don't be afraid. Somebody needs to know that today. Don't be afraid, because Jesus is right there. He's near. Don't be afraid. You're going through a challenge. You're going through a storm. You're in the middle of a circumstance. But God wants you to know that he's right there. And it's all right not to fear. Did you hear that? The Lord wants us to know today that whatever you're in the middle of, you were afraid that it was going to take you out. You were afraid that the waters were going to overflow you and drown you. But God says, it's all right. I am here. Don't be afraid. So come on, let's declare that today. The Lord says, it's all right. My situation, even in the midst of it, it's all right. The Lord is here. And I don't have to be afraid. Hallelujah. And then what does Jesus do? He climbs in the boat. That means now you know I'm with you. And what happens? The wind stops. So as soon as you recognize who Jesus is in your life, as soon as you recognize that he's right there, the wind's got to stop. And they were astonished at what they saw. They couldn't even understand. They didn't even understand the miracle of the loaves. Lord have mercy. Some of us have been in church or have given our lives to the Lord, and we still don't get it. We don't understand the miracle of the loaves, the miracle of his presence, the miracle of us being his children. But beloveds, I want you to be encouraged today to know that God can do the miraculous. You know what he did with those loaves? He thanked the Lord. He gave thanks and they multiplied. Somebody needs to give thanks. Yeah, I know the check looks little. I know it doesn't look like it's going to meet everything, but somebody needs to give thanks. Give thanks for that bread. You know, sometimes we call it money bread. Right, I know that's an old term, but you need to bless that bread, bless that $500, bless that check, bless whatever God has put in your hand, bless it, and let God multiply it. Let God do the increase. Let him cause the increase. Because, beloved, above all, he would that you would prosper, be in health, even as your soul doth prosper. And he shall supply all your needs according to your riches, not yours. See, that's where we get it mixed up. According to your riches? No, it's according to his riches and glory. Last time I read, he has gates made of pearl, walls made of jasper. The streets are paved with gold. Now, if he was poor, I don't think anybody could be walking on golden streets. Walls made of pearl, of a jasper. Our daddy got it all. He's large and in control. He's large and in charge. Just recognize who he is. And again, I want to remind you, the Lord says, it's all right. He is here. Don't be afraid. Come on, let's pray. Father, in the matchless mighty name of Jesus, we give you glory. We give you honor. We give you praise. We just lift your name today. We give you glory and honor. Thank you for being with us. Thank you for seeing us even in the midst of our struggle, in the midst of our challenge, in the midst of our circumstance. Lord God, have mercy upon us. For a minute, we lost focus. For a minute, we forgot about you being our refuge and our strength. For a minute, we lost our focus. But God, we're focused now. We see you and we hear you. Thank you that you are making it all right. Thank you that you are here. Thank you that we don't have to fear. Oh God, we are so grateful that you are our God. Thank you, Jesus, that you intercede for us on our behalf, oh God. Hallelujah. That our faith would fail not. God, thank you. Thank you that you've made us more than conquerors. That God, it's okay that even in the midst of our struggle, in the midst of our trial, in the midst of the storm, Lord God, you don't have a problem climbing into the situation with us. Aramandoshi. Just like you climbed into the boat with the disciples in the midst. Hallelujah. And it wasn't until you climbed into the situation that the wind stopped. So, Father, we invite you, come on in. Come on into our boat. Come on into our homes. Come on into our job. Come on in, Ramandesha. We invite you in, Jesus. Come on in. And God, we know that when you come in, the winds are going to stop just with your presence. So that's why we come. We come in your presence. We come in your presence, oh God. And the winds and waves gotta cease when we're in your presence, oh Lord. We come in your presence. We invite you in, we invite you in to our boats and to our situation. And every complication, we invite you in. Come on in, come on in, come on in. Come on in, for you are Jehovah Shalom. You're the God of peace, our peace. And as you come in, you bring us peace. Thank you. Thank you. We decree and declare today that we will not be moved. We decree and declare that it's all right. It's all right. It's all right. It's all right. We decree that you are here. You are here. You are here. And we don't have to fear. Thank you, God. We again crown you. We reiterate and we decree and declare that you are the Lord of our lives. We crown you as Lord of our lives. We say, yes, you will. Yes, to your way. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth and in our lives as it is in heaven. And because we are your kingdom, God, no thing that is negative, no illness, no sickness, no disease, no poverty, none of that is in heaven. None of that is in your realm or your jurisdiction. So God, we thank you. Thank you for prosperity. Thank you for meeting all our needs. Thank you for healing our body. Thank you, Lord, for strength, life, joy, peace, for in your presence there is fullness of joy. At your right hand there are pleasures forevermore. Thank you, Lord. We're so glad, Lord God, that it's all right, it's all right, it's all right. Because you are here, you are here, you are here. And we don't have to be afraid because you're here, because you're with us. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. That you don't mind getting down and dirty with us, coming down where we are, God, coming into our atmosphere, into our boat, into our ministries, into our homes, into our job. You don't mind coming with us. Thank you, God, because you promised to never leave us nor forsake us. Thank you. Oh, somebody needs to know that he's right there. He's right there. He's right there with you. He's right there and he's saying, it's all right. I'm here. I'm here. There's no need to fear. No need to fear. No need to fear. Oh, I know the winds and the waves may be boisterous, but I am here, I am here, I am here, I am here. And it's all right, it's all right, I'm making it all right. 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 I'm working it out for your good. Oh yes I am, oh yes I'm making it for your good. Just believe, just grab hold of faith. God, we thank you. We believe that you are working on our behalf. We believe it, God. And we are so elated. Thank you. Thank you, Lord, for restoring that one. Thank you, Lord, for increasing faith today. Thank you, Lord, for climbing in our boats. Thank you for seeing our dilemma, seeing our challenge, seeing that we are in trouble, God. Hallelujah. For you are a present help in the time of trouble. Hallelujah. And you see, you care, and you're coming. You're here. And we don't have to fear. Because it's all right. You've made it all right. Thank you. In the mighty, matchless name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. Beloveds, I want you to be reminded, the Lord has climbed up into your boat. And right before he climbed into your boat, he said, it's all right. He's here. Don't be afraid. This has been Moed Shelraga, the appointed time of refreshing. Continue to be blessed, revived, and refreshed in the presence of the Lord. Shalom.